A commuter rights group urges Philippine aviation officials to inhibit from the probe into the New Year's Day travel chaos. The passenger forum says an independent body should conduct the investigation to ensure the process and the findings will be fair.
Mahirap po yung kayo yung iimbestigahan, kayo din yung mag-iimbestiga. Kailangan kasi may accountability kasi po kapag hindi, baka maulit lang ito. Sa katunayan nga po, mayroon lang ilang mga nananawagan na magbitiw sila. Diba? Kami po, pinag-iisipan na rin namin manawagan ng ganyan, pero ang gusto namin makita, ano yung punot doon nito. Kailangan mayroon delikadesa itong mga nagtataapan.
Switching gears now, Baguio City expects more tourists during this year's Panagbanga Festival. Baguio City Mayor Benjamin Magalong says, aside from the annual parade of floral floats, the city government will mount concerts and events with local artists. But the mayor warns of heavy traffic in the city of Pines, especially in February. He adds, Baguio City has been coordinating with police and health officials to ensure that celebrations will remain safe.
Ito na yung festival na talagang kailangan na full blast na kami. Kung ano yung mga ginagawa dati namin noong pre-pandemic, lahat ng features noon kasali na rin ito. Pero nadagdagan pa ng mga ibang mga features. Magdadagdag pa kami ng ibang mga siguro, meron pang mga additional na 3 or 4 na mga events pa to complete yung events ditong entire month ng February.
Former whistleblower and Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office board member Sandra Kham has been cleared of murder charges stemming from the death of a former Masbate mayor in 2019. Let's get more details now from our correspondent Jeffrey Hernaez, who now joins us on the line. Jeffrey, go ahead.
Hi, Ron. The Manila Regional Trial Court, Branch 42, jumped the murder charges against former whistleblower and Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office board member Sandra Kham, San Marco Martin, and 5 other accused, namely Nelson Cambaya, Junel Gomez, Bradford Solis, Juanito de Luna, and Rigor de la Cruz. This is in connection with the murder case filed by the National Bureau of Investigation in 2020 against Kham and the other accused over the October 2019 killing of former Masbate Mayor Charlie Yuzon III in Manila. Kham's legal counsel, attorney Benaventura Miranda, welcomes the court's decision and said they will immediately secure a copy of the resolution so their clients will be released from jail the soonest time possible. Benaventura, however, has yet to talk with Kham. The son of Yuzon, Batuan Masbate Mayor Charmac John Yuzon, meanwhile, expresses disappointment with the ruling and said that they will file an appeal to a higher court. Run.
Jeffrey, you're nice with that report. Thanks.
President Marcos Jr. should not jump the gun on the Maharlika Wealth Fund. That call coming from opposition Senator Risa Ontiveros. She says it would be premature to soft launch the fund in front of world leaders since it has not yet passed the Senate. Ontiveros adds Marcos should only talk about the fund if there is already a portfolio of attractive projects that have been assembled. As for Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, he says promoting the fund before the bill is passed could be a move to tie the hands of Congress, particularly the Senate. For an economist, the Philippines will get a chance to diversify its export markets during Marcos's trip to Davos. Michael Batu notes networking opportunities will be available for Marcos in the forum since elite business leaders will be in attendance. He added, the World Economic Forum also presents an opportunity for the Philippines to bring home business deals with members of the European Union, which is one of the world's major trading blocks.
Yung amount na makukuha niyang investment pledges, that is a signal itong mga namumuhunan na to is meron silang kumpiyansa sa ating economy.